In this video, I'm going to show you how to speed up your workflow with the Script Event Manager in Photoshop. This useful hidden feature will help you get started much faster with your creative projects. Before we get started, I just want to show you the process that you normally would go through when opening a new document and the different things that you do and how you can speed that up. So what I'll do is I'll go into the File menu and select Open, and I can open up a file. So I can open up this photo of a cat, and of course, the document opens up. If I want to edit this image, I might create a new layer to work non-destructively, and I could name it, of course. I'll call it Edits, and I can select the paintbrush tool and select the color that I'm going to work with. So I'll select red as my foreground color. And if I want to take advantage of all the real estate in my screen and remove all distractions, I might just go into the full screen mode. So I can just press F on the keyboard to toggle between the different modes until I get into the full screen mode. Now, I know that that didn't take a whole bunch of time, but it can become very tedious if you have to constantly keep selecting the tool that you want, the color that you want, and creating new layers and things like that. So what Photoshop allows you to do is speed up this whole process with the Script Event Manager. So let me show you how that works. I'm going to escape the full screen mode by pressing the escape key, and that brings back my panels. And I'm going to delete this layer. So I'll select it and hit the delete key. I'll click on this icon to set the foreground and background color. And I'll click on the move tool to deselect the brush tool. So one of the ways in which we can speed this process up is by creating an action. An action is simply a set of recorded commands that you can play at any time. So if you go into Window, Actions, you'll open up the Actions panel. And you can create a new set. I'll call mine PTC Actions. This is just the folder that is going to contain the actions that I create. And then I can click on this icon to create a new action. And I can call this action Starter. And I can give it a color. I'll make it blue and press record. Now Photoshop will record most of the things that I do on screen. For example, if I create a new layer, you can see that it recorded the make layer command. Then I can call it edits. It will record that as well, of course. If I select the brush tool, it will recognize that action. I can also select any color that I want. Photoshop will remember it. However, if I go into the full screen mode by pressing the F key, notice that Photoshop doesn't record that action. Even if I go into view, screen mode, full screen, Photoshop will not record that. So how can you record menu commands? Well, you can click on this four line icon here, the flyout menu, and select insert menu item. Then you can select any menu item that you like. So I can go into view, screen mode, full screen mode. Notice how that is selected here. And then just press OK. And now that menu mode has been recorded. I can press on the stop button. I'll collapse this for now. And I'll delete this layer, make the foreground and background colors default, and select a different tool. And I can come back into the actions panel, click on play. You see how that action plays? It takes me into the full screen mode. I have my new layer, the foreground color that I chose, and the brush tool that's selected. So that works great. But we can even take it one step further by having Photoshop automatically select the action without us doing anything. And that's where the Scripts Event Manager comes into play. So if I go into File, Scripts, Script Events Manager, you'll get this window here. And I know that scripts can seem scary, but don't worry about it. Just think of it as a tool that makes something happen with an event. So I can enable it by clicking on this box. And the first step is to select the Photoshop event. For example, starting the application, creating a new document, opening the document, and several others. What we will use for this tutorial is the open document command. So that means that every time that Photoshop opens a new document, something will happen. And what will happen? That depends. We can select a script, one of the scripts here on this list, or you can select a custom script, which is something you probably won't do. You probably will use an action. So you can select an action that happens when you open a new document. So I can click on this dropdown and select the set that I just created, PTC Actions, and the action that we just created, Starter. And then I can click on the Add button, and you can see now that we have this event, Open Document, that will play the Starter action from the PTC action set. Then I can click on Done. So let me collapse all of this. I'll select the Move tool, set the default to background and foreground colors, and close this document. Now if I open up a new document, for example this city, click on Open, notice now that immediately Photoshop runs that action. I have the image in full screen. I'll hit the Escape key to bring the panels back. You can see that I have a layer named Edits, and I've selected the Brush tool with the foreground color that I wanted. Okay, so now let me show you something else. If you want to edit your action, you can always click on this Actions button to open up the Actions panel, or you can go into Windows, in Action. Then expand the action that you created, and you can adjust it any way that you like. For example, we can click on Select Brush, which is the step that selects the brush, and we can start recording again. So I'll click on the Begin Recording button, and now Photoshop will record new steps. For example, I can select a different brush. So I can click on this down pointing arrow and select any other brush. For example, Kyle's Ultimate Pastel Palooza. You can see that step was added in the actions here, and I can hit the stop button to stop recording. So now I've added a new step. You can of course click on this trash icon to delete a step if you want. What I'll do now is select a different brush, adjust the size from 60 to something else, and set the default background and foreground colors. I'll now close the file. Don't save it. And then if I open up another file, you'll see that Photoshop once again took me into full screen mode, created the edits layer, selected red as my foreground color, selected the brush tool, and that brush that I selected in the action. So as you can see, by using the Scripts Event Manager in Photoshop, you can get started with your images the way you want right away. To disable the Script Event Manager, you can go into File, Scripts, Script Events Manager, and you can simply uncheck the checkbox and click on Done. Also, if you're wondering why I made the action blue, like where does that show? If you go into this icon, the flyout menu, you can select button mode and you can see the actions in button mode, and you can see that Starter is blue. That's simply the color that the button appears under button mode. I'll disable that, and it brings me back to the regular view. If you want to learn more about actions and how to speed up your workflow, then check out my video, 3 Time Saving Tips to Work Faster in Photoshop. Check it out now. I'll place a link right below in the description. But anyway, I hope that you enjoy this tutorial. If you're new to the Photoshop training channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Leave your questions down in the comments below, and I will see you at the next tutorial.